Hey guys, today let's take a look at this ancient temple called Uthirakosamangai. It has some stone carvings which have baffled all experts. There are these statues of large saber-toothed lions called Yalis. But inside the mouth of this Yali is a perfectly spherical stone ball. You can roll this ball, you can rotate it, but it cannot be pulled out of the mouth. People have recently vandalized it and have tried to pull out the ball using force, damaging the statue, which is why it has been closed for public view. How was this mysterious structure created in ancient times? In fact, the state government is so baffled by this artifact that they have recreated modern-day carvings like this and placed all over the state. This is a modern-day recreation. These were created using high-tech machines. Modern sculptors put flexible sculpting tools inside the mouth and carved the ball. Some experts have theorized that ancient builders followed a similar procedure. After carving the lion's mouth, ancient sculptors would have worked for countless days and slowly chiseled this stone ball inside using primitive tools. But locals in the temple area point out to something much more interesting. They say that these modern statues have a serious flaw. In newer statues, the ball inside is the same material as the rest of the structure. Everything is made out of one solid rock. But in this ancient statue, while the lion is made entirely out of one solid block of granite, the ball inside is made of a different material called onyx. Look at the color difference. The statue looks much lighter, while the ball looks black in color. Now, why are we not able to pull the ball out of the lion's mouth? Because the ball is larger in size than the openings in the mouth. But how was the ball, which is made of a different rock, put inside this opening in the first place? The ball is not a flexible rubber ball. It is made of solid rock, so it would be impossible to achieve this without rock melting technology. Remember, I have already shown you clear evidence of rock melting technology at a different temple called Ramapa Temple. So, does this statue prove that ancient builders were melting rocks? How else could such a feat be accomplished? Many tourists see this mind-boggling statue and think that this is also a modern-day creation. But archaeologists confirm that this is older than 600 years. However, the temple was already mentioned in a 9th century text called Uthirakosamangai, making it older than 1200 years. But locals believe that this temple is one of the oldest temples in India, about 3,000 years old. According to locals, this temple was entirely built 3,000 years ago using advanced technology and not primitive tools. As evidence, they point out to this carving. Here you can see an elephant carved inside a 1-inch circle. You can see all its features, including the eyes. So what kind of tools were used in ancient times? The temple contains many strange features. It houses a 5-foot-tall dancing Shiva made entirely out of emerald. There is also a tree, which botanists have confirmed to be at least 3,000 years old. While historians claim that human beings lived a primitive lifestyle 3,000 years ago, What we actually see is evidence of rock melting technology, extremely sophisticated carvings, and proof of an advanced civilization. Did we once have a highly developed civilization which used advanced technology? How else can we explain these evidences? Please let me know your thoughts in the comment section. I am Praveen Mohan. Thanks a lot for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and also click on the bell button to get all the updates. Please give this video a thumbs up and share it with your friends, and I will talk to you soon. Bye.